Mati bangun. Fuck. What is happening?
Fucking hell.
Huh? The belt, just put it back on, yeah?
Okay.
Is the belt okay?
You might be telling me that. This 4 years ago, remember? Now, tell you what happened. It got wet. So I washed the car on Christmas Eve. And took the next day. What the fuck is the light came on?
If it is wet, then it might be the water pump is stuck, no?
No, no, I washed it. I washed it from the car itself.
Oh, okay.
I think it might have been wet
today. Okay. That could be, yeah.
We're going to give it off 20%.
Oh, on the charging?
Yeah, you just checked it from. So, but I
took my insurance. So you just fucked up the thing?
You just fucked it, right?
Fucked up the thing, obviously. And?
You put a new car belt and all of this. Not there, there's a pipe in here.
Okay.
So,
we need to replace the alternator, guys. Because, as they said, here's the guy looking after the alternator. And he said, the alternator charging is bad. So, the guy is using the multimeter. And he shows that the alternator is bad. But actually, if you have no multimeter to test the alternator, if it is charging good or not, you can just disconnect the battery in the positive to negative. But beforehand, you have to start the engine. And then once you start the engine, you have to disconnect in the positive terminal or negative terminal. And once the engine shut down, once you disconnect the terminal, one of the terminal, then the alternator starts charging. That's like a black and white system on how to determine if the alternator is charging. That is, if you don't have the, what it is, the, what you call the multimeter. But the guy has the multimeter, so there's multimeter to use. So. To determine the alternator mode, so that we can change it. So, before doing so, to get access to the alternator, we need to remove the fuel filter. So, the fuel filter has to be removed because it's on our way. But we try not to disconnect the pipes in here. But if necessary to disconnect the alternator pipe, then we can do what we can do. Okay? Just, looks like we have to disconnect. Because this pipe here is brittle. And once it gets brittle, they are make trouble and then we are going to hit. Here is the pipes later on, the pipes, this is thick, this is just like a protective housing. Okay, disconnect the pipe here, this is the in or the delivery, and here is the out, or going to the chamber, so disconnect, and also disconnect here, and also this is to disconnect motor, but you see, okay, so to remove the alternator, I mean the fuel filter here, we have to step down, thing we have here, this one here, some other reason. It's really, suck. It's like the Volvo engineering design here, it's really suck. It's very complicated, like. So, this is just, we're gonna fry out. So, we're gonna fry out, guys, after removing the top bolts here, top screw. Fry it out like that. And then, see this one here? This is the pipe, that's the biggest problem. We have to take this out. Doesn't need to disconnect. You just take down the clip here. I'm doing so. Like that. Just cut the clearance here and then the monitor here for the sensor. Like that, like that. And then let's go ahead. Like that. We have now the full view on the alternator here. And beforehand. Before you disconnect, before do anything about alternator, guys, you have to disconnect the battery. Okay? So we are doing the battery disconnect here. Let's continue. Let's do it here. I have to go back like that, so you can see the whole view. Okay, and what we're gonna do, so after disconnecting the battery, then you may disconnect the connector from the alternator here, and you're gonna need to take care to fry out the connector in the other room, like so. Here, this is the cover for the main connection. And that is attacking me. The main connection here. Okay. And then we're gonna do the holder or the housing. And this is 10 mil Let me get this thing quick. Green a little. Should go faster, guys. So here. Then I remove the hard disk bolt first. Then we put it back on. The easiest bolt to be down first. So we will take position on the thread easily. Get along the thread. So here. This is so much for the engineering design. So here. So here. This is the housing for the alternator. The fuel filter. I know you have the alternator here now. So before to remove the loosen the alternator, you're gonna have to like the worst scenario here is the belt engineer. That's the very worst scenario here, belt engineer. But yeah. Okay. We're gonna need like a 60 mil or 50 mil. I don't know. To remove the alternator here. Okay. For now we didn't remove the drive belt on the belt engineer itself. We just pop it down the alternator easily and then it's the same result. We remove the belt by popping down the alternator. So and then remove the bolt here down. Removing the alternator. It's a 60 mm bolt here. 60 mm bolt. So how will you need to see? So from here. So pop it down and then there you go. You can now get access to the alternator and then bolt inside. Then once you remove that, you're gonna move the alternator side to side to take it out. It doesn't need to remove this one here, like this is like a U-bolt. Doesn't it? It doesn't need to remove the U-bolt because it's kind of more job going on. Tinanggal mo yung parang yung more U-bolt na nakatrip yung sa kanya. Let's try natin yung squash down natin yan. Let's squash down. You can see. So, try to move faster here and return. Like that's the bolt here. It's the last one. It's a 60 mil. It's kind of long, like maybe it's 5 mil, 6 mil length, centimeter. And then like 6 millimeter bolt. Like the length. I mean, I'm thinking about the length. But this is 16 millimeter bolt. Like on the ratchet, it's 16. And then, now, yeah, you see it can wiggle around. Looks like we're almost done here. Okay, bolt now. We're gonna wiggle this alternator here. Should be this, kind of hard. I'm gonna be done the one hand, so. Looks like here. Okay. Let's put this on. Looks like the bolt that's holding the alternator. So kind of shooting the deal with it. Not anything. Sweden. Volvo is made in Sweden. And we are designing engines that are very, very hard to put up the parts. See. So we need to move. Okay, what we need to move? You know the reason why this thing here is harder? Because of this. Because of this thing here. See this one? That is kind of hard. So, pull it back. We're gonna loosen down. Loose it a little bit. So, it will be easy for us to put back on. So that's too tight. Okay, that's it. Loosen up. Two tons. And this belt engineer here, we're gonna lock position. We're gonna swing it around and then put the locking pin. So, we will. Okay, so 16 mil. 16 mil here. You're gonna try this on, take on the position, and then put the pin here. So it will be easy to install later on.
The spring's broken. That's why you put on for your
See that?
It's stuck again. Spring's stuck.
Yeah, we bought that one down
the road. Okay,
yeah. Remember you changed something.
Yeah,
but that was second hand,
that's
why.
Yeah.
So there's no...
Obviously, you can actually tell I can feel that fucking go.
Obviously, you need another one.
Ah, the FCT, so let me have to do it.
So. You know why? Because that is Volvo.
Volvo's the best.
Always need your one.
Yeah. Yeah, I could feel that last week. Can I hit a pump?
Because it's fuck. Situated the connector, the pins here, I correct, like this area, three pins. And also here, the new one is three pins as well. So, installation is like installation is just like here. So this guy here, this is from the old one. This is like a solid round thing, solid round bar. You have to transfer from old to the new one. I'm gonna slide it down now. Slide it down slowly. Yeah, put the thing like that together. Like so. I just wiggle it around in order to get inside. You need to push much easier like that. Need really fry bar to push it down. Okay. Beforehand, you're gonna tighten it a little bit because if you don't, this will make some crazy noise. Before we put it in the final position, tighten it down just a little bit. Right? Two tones. Okay, that's enough. Fill up the gap. And then put the bolt in the bolt into the thing. And this inside. Okay. We're putting the bolt now. Do this job. Here we go, thing is in place. So we need the bolt to compress that round thing at the round one. So we need the bolt to do its job to completely compress that the other side. So you can see, slowly and slowly. We need to do it faster because I'm afraid that it will be raining, so we don't cut by the rains. So we need the bolt to this compress here. Compress here. And when it is compressed, we will put it down here, take it to the final position. This here has the turning first. Don't tighten up until you have this on the position. So it will go easily on the thread inside. And there's no mess up here. Okay? So position all the bolts first. Tighten it down. for the basket. I'm getting. So once the bolts are in position, like so, and tight. Okay, that's fine. And always remember to disconnect the battery, yeah? So there's no danger here. Since we disconnect the battery already. So we still have something. We'll just drop the lock. Okay. Let's click on. Now just click at the lock. And then, yeah. And then, bring this in like this. Okay. Then I have to fight on the belt tensioner. Okay. So guys, belt is in position now. Like, so you have here 17 mil on the belt tensioner, and then pry out. And it's very, very tricky because it has limited space here between the body, so you have to like make your own way on how to bring the thing down, like 17 mil. Grab here. So we're gonna put it back on and we'll do the start engine. Okay, there's 40,000 on there. So grab one, and it's loaded with 10 mil bolts. Okay, there's 10 mil bolts. This will be your guide. You start here. That's the guide. And then you sit it down. There are only three bolts that's holding the system, like the frame, some frame. So frame. And then there's a tool. You watch it. It pass. Last one here. Okay. And then put it the cover here. Put it there. Okay. And then once you've done that, you can now install the fuel filter. Like so. Easy. And then you have here the hook. Okay, like that. And then once you've done that. In position, all the wiring time. Take position. All this here, like that. And here, lock down. Connector here. Before the connector, you have to put the hanger. And put the connector cover. Okay, this goes around with 3 bolts. And 10 more bolts. Pack the connector here. So no need to bleed because the thing here, the fuel filter has still fuel on it, so it doesn't need to be bleed. Just put up the connector. Then start the engine. One time. shot. Yeah. Again.
Okay.
Yeah. Now we have to bleed. Bleed again. We'll bleed about 1 liter, is that okay? Yeah? Put the key second position, yeah? Ignition second position, yeah. Now? Keep going. You have the fucking sounds like there is fuel leaking on this thing. Huh?
Yeah,
right. Fuel leaks? I don't know.
No. We'll use
ventilation. This machine should start once we put the like, steering on this one.
Sorry, the so this, you need to heat the pump, so you don't matter with.
So
still
driving
yesterday.
Control
field,
okay,
check.
It's
just the battery right now. Because
looking at the
high-pressure
tank on that,
still
you have to fuel totally. Totally. Yeah, it built up because when we drain, it's coming out. You know what I mean? See that? So the fuel filter is full.
Oh, the fuel is not good.
No, no, the fuel filter is full.
These are right. What? Should I be on maybe that one or you know?
No, no, no.
What's the fuel like?
Something to do has no place to pump. It's time to start. Once this is done, shut down. Okay. Oh, just keep starting, man. Don't drop it. Come on.
Start it over.
Yeah. When you start the engine, don't pump the gas, yeah?
Okay.
Don't pump the gas because it will drown, you know?
Okay.
It will drown.
Right, yeah.
Not yet. Don't pump the gas, just leave it running like. Don't pump the gas. Because she is drowning like. Lily, don't pump the gas, yeah? No. Is it pumping the gas? What? Go again, go again. No.
There's nothing here. Ask me something to do with this place. Ask me something to do with this place. Okay. What do you mean? Well, we just don't change this problem. It has to be something like this. When you take this off, what's underneath that? Just flat?
Oh, that's flat.
There's no filter.
Nothing. Just flat. See this? You can feel it here. Feel it. Here. I only remove this one. I didn't swing around like that. Flapping. Yeah. Flapping. Wait. Di sini ada apa?
Definitely on right
now. There's no point in the trip. No.
We'll take it. Really supply here. Okay.
That's great. What I mean is, when it goes wrong, we have to twist a bit.
Yeah.
That is. It will rotate because the lock is only here.
Yeah.
Like it will rotate like nine. Once it's in,
it's
in. Only thing.
Yeah.
We will drag this down. Engage, you can get.
Huh?
Pull it, yeah, of course. Then pull it. And go. Pull. Last thing. That's the worst scenario we're doing.
Alright. Yeah, yeah.
Last scenario. Because it's not sucking.
You saw the forward engine. You're fucking, but it goes down behind the
stairs, right? Yeah. These are more science kind of thing.
We're number four fans now. You run over these on the big fucking eggs and you're done. So it makes enough to compensate.
That would go right over. Okay, don't start it. We have to fall.